on the news. I imagine sun-kissed beaches, women laughing and tanning under the sun, trying to pretend I'm not uncomfortable in front of men who study my figure, then go home to their wives. In front of ladies who have seen more than 40 pairs of breasts today. In front of silent souls who have walked through these same doors before me in hopes that doctors will find it soon enough. Praying to someone they are losing faith in, and that surgery, pills, or chemo can save me. Today, they spotted my lump and labeled it with a small round sticker outlined in metal. Politely, I'm asked to wipe off my deodorant, wrap a lead blanket around my waist, to pose for the nurse, one arm resting on the machine, that frightened look in my eyes. Do you think I'll be centerfold? I ask, waiting for some trace of comfort in her laugh. Finally, she smiles, asks me to hold still, don't move or breathe. One flash and my breasts are center stage for everyone to observe and dissect. In the waiting room, I sit patiently between magazines and articles, people walking by with the same fear-stricken look in their eyes. I pretend I'm not scared while I watch as the nurses escort the women to the rooms where condolences are given. That is not the room I want to visit. I imagine leaving here with positive results. How would I continue to live my life? To see my future as anything but shattered? What trips would I take? Where I would want to spend my final days? Listening to waves washing against shorelines like my untold promises. My fate awaits me. Pulse quickens. Hands respire. Mind starts to race. And my name's called. Woo!